Prime Minister Rishi Sunak has committed to bringing forward a review of statutory guidance on relationships and sex education. It comes after he was presented with a letter signed by 50 MPs and a 130-page report documenting unsuitably sexually explicit teaching resources. An investigation led by Miriam Cates MP revealed inappropriate materials have been in use since at least 2019, when the Department for Education issued guidance in consultation with LGBT lobby group Stonewall. Since June last year, the department has promised at least four times to write to schools to emphasise the rights of parents to see materials taught to their children, but has so far failed to do so. The Prime Minister made the pledge in response to a question from Cates, who called for an independent inquiry into the nature and extent of the safeguarding scandal.
Graphic lessons on oral sex, how to choke your partner safely, and 72 genders. This is what passes for relationships and sex education in British schools. Across the country, children are being subjected to lessons that are age inappropriate, extreme, sexualising, and inaccurate, often using resources from unregulated organisations that are actively campaigning to undermine parents. This is not a victory for equality, it is a catastrophe for childhood. Will my right honourable friend honour his commitment to end inappropriate sex education by commissioning an independent inquiry into the nature and extent of this safeguarding scandal?
Can I say I share my honourable friend's concerns and thank her for her work in this area. That's why I've asked the Department for Education to ensure that schools are not teaching inappropriate or contested content in RSHE. Our priority should always be the safety and well-being of children, and schools should also make curriculum content and materials available to parents. As a result of all of this, we are bringing forward a review of RSHE statutory guidance and we'll start our consultation as soon as possible.
The Institute's Head of Education, John Denning, is with me now. John, thank you for joining me. What's your take on this?
Well, it was always obvious that without very clear safeguards enforced by Ofsted, that the agenda of sexual radicals would end up pushing its way into schools. And it really is a scandal that this has been allowed to happen. But it's great to see that the tireless efforts of Miriam Cates and others continually raising this in Parliament has forced politicians to take their heads out of the sand and recognise what is happening and is leading to action. But we're not there yet. We need to keep praying that this review is both thorough and rapid and leads to real change on the ground in schools.